What's up, guys? You got Dom here today, and I am going to be bringing you the first episode of my new Let's Play. It is Pokemon Vega. I'm extremely excited to play this game. It looks amazing. A lot of the fake mon look very authentic. They did an overall awesome job on it. I'm really excited because I get to have that experience of, like, I have no idea what Pokemon are in it besides, like, the few I've seen, where I can go through the game and I'll see something in the grass I've never seen before and I'll be like, oh, cool, I wonder what that does. And I have not had that since I was 8 years old and got my copy of Pokemon Ruby and Sapphire. So, yeah, without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into the game. Yeah, we all know all this stuff. I used to hate this every time I wanted to start over and, Fire Red and Leaf Green.
Ah, you are finally here. Welcome to the world of Pokemon. My name is Holly. People refer to me as the Pokemon Professor. This world is inhabited far and wide by creatures called Pokemon. For some people, Pokemon are pets. Others use them for battling. And others use them power to help people in danger. As for myself, I study Pokemon as a profession. But first, tell me a little about yourself. Now, tell me, are you a boy or are you a girl?
I am a boy, sir. He's dressed like he's about to go out in the winter or something. Let's begin with your name. What is it? I'll go ahead and put Dom. In all caps. Whoops, that's not what I meant to do. What is start button? Enter? No, V. Yeah, there you go.
Right, so your name is Dom.
Yep.
Now, let's talk about this boy. He's studying to become a Pokemon Ranger.
What was his name now? I'm gonna name him... Jar. He's my biggest competition.
Was it Jar? Yep, that's right. I remember now. His name is Jar. Dom! Your very own Pokemon legend is about to unfold. A world of dreams and adventures with Pokemon awaits. Let's go.
So it's a standard house from Fire Red and Leaf Green. Let's see if I got a potion in here. Will definitely help me not lose the Nuzlocke immediately. And I do have my potion. Alright, I'll bounce up out of here. This is running at 60 FPS, so I don't know if FPS qualifies here, but whatever it is, it's running really smoothly and I like it a lot.
Dom, the running shoes! You've used up to this point won't work on these snowy roads, so take these.
A new pair of running shoes. You know, Mom coming through the new Nike Air Maxes. And the town map. Don't even have to talk to Gary's sister.
By the way, your father was asking for you. You should probably go see him.
I hate doing voices so badly. At least I don't have webcam, so I don't have to be super self-conscious. I actually made the overlay and realized I didn't leave room for a webcam, but it's just as well because, my computer's not the best and probably would have struggled a little bit. Let's see, is that you, Sin?
Sorry for bothering you, but I need you to come in with me to the lab.
Ah, Charles here too. In that case, I'd like to ask two of you to...
Tra-la-la-la-la. Hey, it's me, Moss. M-O-S.
I don't know what kind of person this is. I don't know what voice to make just yet.
Oops, raw? It would be a lot better cooked.
Professor, who's the strange man?
Oh, that's... I am the Moss. My name is Moss Muro. Remember 12, because it'll be on the next test.
Sorry, Moss Muro, but could you let me speak for a little while?
Aw, oh, okay.
Mosmero is my old friend. Dom, you're familiar with him too, right? I actually called him over here because I needed to ask him a favor as well. Well, I think I've gotten a bit off track. Let's get to the real issue here. I called the two of you out here because I have a favor to ask of each of you. First, Dom, you might have heard about this, but recently Pokemon species first thought to appear due to meteors in Hoenn have started to appear here in Tohoku Region. The reason why they started to appear is an interesting research topic in itself. As a stepping stone to that, I'd like to ask you to take an ecological survey of the current Pokemon in the Tohoku region.
Man, these lazy-ass professors never changes.
Well, go find your own Pokemon. And in order to encourage you to research things in a fresh new way, I'll be taking care of the Pokemon that you used in Hoenn here at the lab. Sorry, but it has to be this way. Next, Jar, I've heard that you're studying to be a Pokemon Ranger. I want you to deliver this secure styler to Jackie in Something City. He can make the final adjustments needed to get it working. I would never trust Jar with the secure styler. He'd steal it, keep it for himself.
Understood. Leave it to me. And now, mission start!
Ah, wait. Trying to capture Pokemon on your own would be dangerous, wouldn't it? I'll give you your own Pokemon. Oh, and you too, of course, Dom.
Thank you!
I have a feeling that I'm gonna be left out of this. I guess I'm out of here.
Ah, wait, Mesmero. I need to give...
Ah, yes. Okay, I'll take good care of this. Mesmero, mission start!
Well then, Dom and Jar. There are three Pokemon sitting on this desk. I'll let each of you have one of them. Now choose. Let's see here.
Oh, I'm getting a call from headquarters. Dom, I guess you can choose first.
Is it the grass one? Yeah, I think I want to go with Sprout Pokemon Nimbleaf. Liquid Putt. Highly balanced Pokemon, so Dom, you decide on the Liquid Pokemon. Pyro is your choice. It's like Peyote, or I don't know what it's supposed to be based off of. It's a firmly defensive Pokemon. So Dom, you're claiming the Gunpowder Pokemon, Pyro. These starters look so cool. I really like that Leaf starter though. I'm definitely going with this. Yep. This Pokemon is really quite energetic. Got the first member. Not bad, not bad. Yes, I do want to give him a nickname. Let's see. What would I name this thing? Looks like a grass monkey lizard thing. I'm gonna name it Mowgli from the Jungle Book. I don't know why, but that's just gonna be his name. I think that's how you spell it. I hope so. Oh well. If not, that means he's gonna choose the fire thing. I need to get a water type stat. Alright, you may not have your old Pokemon, but as long as you have this one, you'll be fine. Unless it dies.
Hey, wait up! We just got our Pokemon, so how about a little battle?
Alright, let's see if we can beat Jar. Alright, let's do this, Mowgli. Blah, blah, blah. Everyone knows that battle. I wouldn't be playing this if I didn't know how to play Pokemon. Alright, I'll go right for Scratch. It's probably not going to do very much at all. He is defensive. Now we're doing about the same amount of damage. I'm doing maybe a little bit less. I'm going to go for Tail Whip. And as long as I don't get crit, I can live one more attack and then I can use that potion. Sorry for speeding up, I just am really jumpy with using it. So this is your Pokemon, Dom. Open this is blah 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 blah. Shut up, Professor. And these animations and the talking just takes forever. Alright, I'll just scratch here. And we got our first battle victory. We beat Jar. Ah, nice and level 6. So it looks like it's got, pretty good attack and speed and, I guess, decent special attack. I don't know what nature it is just yet.
I guess I need to train first.
Yes, excellent. If you win, you earn prize money and your Pokemon will go. Battle other trainers and make your Pokemon strong.
Well, I better get going. We'll meet again sometime. Mission start!
Unfortunately, I wasted my, first potion, I feel like, kinda. Am I able to get Pokeballs yet? Or is there a Mart or anything in this town?
I'm gonna assume not. It's over here. Wait, is this the right way to go? I guess that was the right way to go. Let's see if this old man has anything for me. Bird, this cold weather is bad for my old bones. Sorry, I didn't get any character before I did that. Oh, let's check out Mowgli's stats. Grass type, quirky. I think quirky is... If I'm not mistaken, quirky is neutral. Thick fat. That is really sweet. So both of my weaknesses are covered. I wonder what the other one's abilities were. That's an awesome ability though. So far, I'm really impressed with this game. I think they did a really good job with it. It's almost... I don't want to say a shame that I have to play it as a Let's Play, because I would really like playing this game just on my own free time. In fact, if I can figure it out, I might even make a separate file for myself. Got so many Pokemon that my party's full. Or rather, I can store some in PC boxes. The power of science is amazing! Wait, is he supposed to be based on Clement from the anime? He must be a rookie trainer, right? Here, you can have these if you want. Oh, sweet, 5 Pokeballs. Okay, so I guess the lock has officially started.
To capture Pokemon, you need Pokeballs. However, don't just throw one immediately. You need to weaken it first, then throw the ball. That's the secret to catching Pokemon.
Alright, so I'm going to do my best to actually stay out of the grass. Oh shit, there's trainers over here. Alright, so I'm going to hope I don't die. Like now. And I am going to... Alright, Taylor doesn't get picked yet, if I'm not mistaken. I'm gonna hope I don't freaking die to these two mons, and then what I'm gonna do is go back to the town. I'm gonna grind a little bit and then catch my first mon. Oh, whichever one comes first. So if I got crit there, that would have been really, really bad. Hopefully, he doesn't have another Taylor. So Mowgli's gonna go. Level up to 7. So he's growing pretty fast. Special attack boosted. So I'm guessing a special attack and attack are kind of even base stat wise. He's got high speed. I get absorbed, so I got my stab now. So I'm like a nice little mixed attacker, like Sceptile, I guess. Unfortunately, he has 2 of these stupid fucking things. But we're doing a lot more damage now that we, we were doing a lot more damage since the level up, but. We should be able to pull through unless we get crit by Peck or something. So we live that. I almost want to see how much Absorb does. Yeah, I'll do it just for fuck's sake. If anything, I get a couple points of health back. Or 1 point of health, yeah. So he goes for Peck, and unless there's like some crazy speed tie, or... Alright, yeah, so Taylor goes down. That was a little bit close. I probably shouldn't have played around with the Absorb that close to death. Alright, I am going to run my ass back to my hometown and heal my mons, first off. Because I wasn't expecting them to throw you right into the midst, right off the bat to be able to catch Pokemon and have trainers and whatnot. Normally they... have like a little intermediate town at the beginning where nothing really happens. So mom's looking out. We got all healed up. And we will run to the grass, and I actually think we can go ahead and get our first encounter. And we'll get them to like level 8 or 9, I guess. Just for safety's sake. Alright, so ironically, Taylor is our first mon, and I'm not mad about that at all. I love Taylor. I'm just gonna scratch him. 2 should do it. I don't want to stay in here too long. I'm probably going to throw one Pokeball, and if it doesn't catch it, I'm going to have to kill it. Because I can't risk staying in on this. So hopefully it stays in the ball. Fuck. Do I risk the crit? Nope, not worth it to me. I'm just gonna have to make our first encounter go down. So we lost our first encounter. Little unfortunate, but I guess we'll push through. And I've gotten a level 8. And I pretty much have no choice but to just run through the grass, and since my other Pokemon's not getting the experience, I don't really feel like grinding at all. I don't feel like I need to, because I'm in a comfortable level, like 4 levels above the things I'm finding. Alright, there we go. I really like the way they designed the world so far. Everything's all snowy. So it's looking like it's just a bunch of Talos. So for wild battles like that, I'm just gonna speed up through just for the sake of time. Are you serious? I could have gotten a freaking Glaceweld. That thing is so cool. I'm gonna absorb it and get some HP back. Yeah. So I get to stay at full health and I'm getting this experience. That's pretty good. That sucks. That Glaceweld thing is really cool. It's like an Ice Ralts. Who knows? Maybe we'll find an opportunity to get another one later. We get a potion, which is great. So another Glaceweld. I'll just go ahead and kill that too. So we're almost level 9. I don't want to do too much grinding and be too overleveled. It'll also make catching my first Pokemon harder, which actually happens to me a lot in Nuzlocke. So everyone seems to have Talos for some reason. Wow, that did a lot. Those Pecs are doing a really uncomfortable amount of damage, and they're definitely adding up. So level 9, let's see what kind of stat boost we get. So it seems like attack and special attack keep like creeping and pumping a little bit ahead of each other. I really like Mowgli so far though, it's a cool mon. If he has explosion on this early in the game, then that's just bullshit. Alright, so he's got protect. I'm pretty sure all it should know is tackle though. Yeah, that's not doing much. Alright, just gonna spam protect. I'm gonna speed it up just to get through this. So we knock out Pineco. Get a good amount of XP. I don't know how far over the next town is, so I'm kind of nervous to keep going through here. I'm gonna play it safe. I'm just gonna go back and heal. I'm not trying to lose the lock this early. Although honestly, yeah, I can just absorb whatever is in the grass to get health back. I'm gonna just kill whatever this is. So it's a Talo. Alright, yeah, I have to go back to Pokemon Center because I can't guarantee I'm gonna find Glaceweld I can heal up on. And plus I don't wanna lose out on any PP. I'm gonna run. Surprised one of those ladies doesn't heal your mons for you. Sorry, I'm getting a little bit of the sniffles. The sniffs. Make the long journey back to where we came from. Holy crap, oh that was a crit. Alright, so we made it to level 10 actually. Gust, wow. Does it turn into grass flying? That would be sick. Thick fat with grass flying. Que interesante.
I'm cold, like, really cold. I need to do this.
Well, if you weren't wearing a skimpy dress, then you wouldn't be cold, woman. That would be cool. Gosh, I love this game so far. I'm, like, enjoying this, and, like, a lot. Like, I had high hopes going into it. And, like, I literally don't want to stop playing. So I'm just going to go for Absorb again. That gust will help me kill other grass types as well as bugs. So that'll definitely come in handy, definitely. This might kill. It might be a roll. Yeah. So we knock Togepi out. And we can get that delicious experience. Sweet. Is there anything down here? Nope, not looking like it. More Talos, I'll just get rid of that. Oh, excuse me. You battle?
I'll battle with the new Pokemon I found recently.
I don't get why little girls are allowed to just be out. Oh, I guess you do get to become a Pokemon trainer at age 10, but still. You wouldn't see my daughter out there. No siree. So Thick Fat makes it so I don't really have anything to fear from, like, Powder Snows or anything, if that's what it has. I'm just gonna go for Scratch. I feel like it has better Spit Death than it does defense. Hence having Charm instead of, I don't know, whatever lower special attack. Big Tears, is that what it is? Alright, so we're almost level 11. We're super over-leveled because we missed out on that Talo. Unfortunately. But actually, if this is going to be a part flying type, then it's kind of good that we don't have Talo. The only downside is we don't have anything to sack if we ever need to. So hopefully, I'll be get to the next town, and there'll be a route after that I can attempt to get my first Mon. Don't know why I didn't just go for Absorb there. Alright, so we're level 11, not bad. So those attack and special attack stats are still looking even. I'm probably gonna end up with a lot more special, more special attack and speed because Talo and Glaceon, I'm assuming, give you special attack EVs. Can I fit through here? No. Is this a different route? Oh, 501, 502. So actually, hold on, let me write down and keep track of this and my notes on my phone. So route 501, Talo got killed. And then we have route 502, and we will see what our encounter here is. Give me something good, please. Please give me something good. And it is another fucking Talo. Alright, let's make the best of it. So I marked down it was a Talo here, and I'm gonna absorb. I think Scratch probably killed it in one hit. And because I'm so much higher level than this, I shouldn't really have too much to fear from it. I'm just absorb again. I don't think this is a 3-hit KO. It might be. Yeah, it is. That actually sucks because Talo didn't look like it wanted to stay in the ball last time. Yeah, there's not really anything I can do besides throw Pokeballs now. Stay in there, you beautiful bird. Please stay in there. Please. Thank you so much. Sweet, we got a Taylor. Not bad, I love Swilla. Hopefully it has guts, that'd be sweet. Sorry, I meant to read the entry, but I forgot about that. Yes, I'll give it a name to Taylor, and I like to name my Taylor Swiftstream. Because it's based off of the animal of Swift. Will it fit? Swiftstream. I guess that's gonna have to do. Can Rock do anything? Nope. So I'm gonna start switch training Swiftstream just so Mowgli doesn't get too far over leveled. Well, this game is actually kind of punishing, it seems like, because alright. So I literally have to run all the way back here and heal because I can't risk Taylor dying. There's a double battle right there. I need it to be at least level... I don't know. Alright, I'm just gonna switch train him up a little bit. I actually might... If I figure out, I'm actually new to Camtasia, so I don't really know how to do it too well. But if I figure out how people like do the like speed up grind sessions, then I'm gonna try and do that. That was close. Level 4. Focus energy. Cool, cool, cool. Hopefully I can get back without running through any grass. Alright, we made it safely. But yeah, this is, I'm surprised they're throwing all these trainers at me before giving me another town or even a Pokemon Center to go to. But if it was easy, it would be a lot less fun to play, so... I like challenging where they, like, throw things in there where you have to think to get past, not things where they're just, like, tedious or, like, they just throw a whole bunch of shit at you for no reason. Like, if you're gonna make it difficult in an intellectual way, not just, like... an annoying or unfair way. Like, what game was it I was playing? It was Insurgents, I think. And the game was awesome. Like, the premise, like, all of the Delta Mons and stuff, the story, all that is cool. But when I got to the third gym leader, and my Pokemon were, like, level 28, and then there's, like, a, what was it, like, 36 or something, Beedrill, and I was intending to Nuzlocke it, I was so pissed because, like, how do you beat a Mega Beedrill? Literally, my entire team got bodied. I could not do anything against it. No matter how cold it may be, I will remain devoted to shorts. Shit, that was funny. Challenge my youngster Josh. Send out Nidoran. Actually, well, it probably has Poison Point. Nidoran has Peck, though. I don't know what I do. Why not? It actually did a lot. As long as I don't get poisoned. And even if I do, if I have guts. So, Swiftstream has gotten her first kill. There you go, level 5. On the climb. Even though there's a lot of trade-ins, at least all the Pokemon seem to be at level like 4. So, they're fairly low level. So, it's just good experience early on, I guess. I can never complain about that. Just pound. So I'm glad it doesn't have Powder Snow because I really actually had to fear that. That's a cheat. Taylor's actually low-key really strong. Like early game. Sweet. I'll stay in. He can't kill me even with the crit. At least I'm pretty sure. And I'm pretty sure I'll probably 2-hit KO this. I'll probably 2-hit KO with the roll. Be doing a lot better when I get Wing Attack at level 13, I think it is, or 11. He does not get the crit, and I am able to knock him out with a Peck. So I'm glad I decided to let Taylor stay in and took that risk. So I'm level 7. So Taylor can pretty much hold its own at this point. And I can always switch into Mowgli if I get in any trouble. Cool. Nonetheless, the outcome of a Pokemon battle depends partly on luck. That is so true. No truer words have ever been said. This game is at least 25% RNG based. Send out Togepi. I shouldn't, and I say that tentatively, shouldn't have anything to worry about with Togepi. So stream's getting kind of low, so I'm gonna go into Mowgli just to ensure I don't lose Taylor. I don't want to ever have to sack Taylor, but so I'm gonna try my best to preserve it and make sure it actually lives and becomes able to evolve and be a valued member of the team. So far, I'm proud of it. It's doing a good amount of work. All this thing. Wait, doesn't it only know Growl? Actually, I don't know why I switched out. Because I think it learns Metronome at level like 6 or something like that. So this is literally like free experience. I'll remember that next time. So Togepi is fainted. Mowgli. So he's gonna send out Glaychild. I'm gonna switch back in and then probably switch back into Mowgli. Sends out Glaychild. Well, no, you don't have Powder Snow. All you have is Pound, and I'm pretty sure you're fairly weak. Yeah, Charm and Pound. These are the times where I can be a little bit reckless and stay in, so I don't have too much to fear. Once they get to all the like level 7 and like where they're learning their first elemental moves, though, I'll have to be a lot more careful. Alright, level 15 or level 8. I mean, I saw 15 on the stats. Learned Quick Attack, not bad. I have another stat besides Peck, even though they're both the same base power. I'm gonna go up here. So we made it to the other town, to the next. Wait, this route. Oh my gosh, this is such a troll. Please, let me find a Pokemon Center. I'm begging you. I can go get that Pokeball that was down here. Oh, it's a Pokeball. Inside of a Pokeball. Cool. I'm actually gonna do this battle. I don't think I really have anything to face from, or fear from either of these. Probably like Glaychild and Taylor. Glaychild on Glaychild. Oh, Nidoran and Nidoran. Interesting. I'll just peck this guy and I will scratch this guy. I'd rather ensure one is dead and then attack both of them and leave one of them alive. So I guess these don't have Poison Point, which is really good because it would be really gay if, forgive me, I don't like saying that. I'm sorry about that. It'd be stupid if I got poisoned and I'm walking around and I lose one of my mons because there's not a Pokemon Center anywhere near. Wow, that Nidoran is bulky as shite. Alright, now I'm gonna finish Nidoran off with Gust, just so even if they are Poison Point, I'm just getting lucky. There's no way I'm gonna lose a mon to poison. I guess I was a little bit more afraid than I needed to be, but I don't want to let my guard down because a lot of ROM hacks start out easy and then they like jump in difficulty like really, really, really fast. Like Insurgents, for example. Although Insurgents, I guess, was never really easy necessarily. We'll catch your Sammy, my Pine Echo. I would not be surprised if Peck didn't, if Peck Oko'd. So he's just gonna protect. It's actually kind of annoying that that's all the Pine Echoes ever do. So Protect fails. It is a Pine Echo after all. Or Pineco, I don't remember how you say it. Yep, level 9. So Taylor's quickly catching up to Mowgli. Got some nice stats going on. lost because of the cold. Yeah, you keep telling yourself that, bud.
Hello there, would you like to have a battle with me?
More little girls. Georgia. Gonna go right for Peck. And that almost knocks him clean out. And I'll just go for quick attack. Just because. Faster animation than Peck. Togepi, no I will not, because Togepi should not be able to touch me unless it's level 5 or 6, I forget what it is. Alright, so this thing probably has Metronome. I'm still going to stay in though. Metronome, yeah, please, I swear if it's like Thunder or something, I'm going to be so pissed. A-Release. Yeah, that did nothing. I'm literally playing with RNG. Alright, so she goes for Growl, thankfully. Or even worse, what if it was like a Metronome Explosion? Nice and level 10, so now they're pretty much equal. I think I'm gonna go back to training Mowgli now. Just out of curiosity, actually, I'm gonna see what nature this is. Lax. That's either neutral or like plus defense or something like that. I won't mind having a bulky Swallow. I'm going to beat you with my incredible Pokemon. Alright, let's see what you got, bud. My youngster, Timmy.
I'm Timmy Turner.
So I can go for Gust here, actually. He's probably just going to go for Protect as usual. Nope. He just stays in. I guess he went for Tackle. That knocked him clean out. Mowgli is actually really strong. I like it a lot. I wonder what the other Mon stats are going to be like, though. Glade Childs. How to stay in. Again, Thick Fat makes it so I don't really have that big of a fear from Ice types. And it doesn't even know Powder Stone yet, I don't think. Yep, just Charm. So I literally just pretty much got free levels. I'm kind of upset. If I had caught that first Halo, then I could have gotten a Glade Child. It's okay, though. Level 12. Look at those stats. It's beautiful. Four more levels till I evolve, I think. If it's 16, just like every other Pokemon game. Could be 14 for all I know. Like how Gold and Silver was. Golava evolved at 14 and then 36. Then Meganium was 16 and 32. And then for Alligator, the weirdest start, it's 18 and 30. Junopsis City. Come on! Can I please find a Pokemon Center? I'm begging you. I've gone through 3 routes and there's still no Pokemon Center. And a Houndour, you said? Oh shit. He roars. That's actually good. I'll get to spread out my experience. I'll go for Peck. Houndour goes down. And Echo comes out. Just go for Peck. Knock that clean out. 37 EXP, and then Nidoran, and yeah, I do think I want to switch out for that. And a Mowgli. Sorry I'm speeding up, the recording's going on a little longer than I wanted to, because I was honestly expecting to find a Pokemon Center way before this. And is this a city? Finally, yes, Junopsis City, sweet, sweet, sweet. So I'm going to find the Pokemon Center, save, and then I guess the first gym is here. So next episode we will There's Pokemon. Oh, that is such a cool design. I like that a lot. Next episode, we'll take on the first gym leader, I assume. Well, definitely. And we'll see if we can find another encounter anywhere past here before we have to beat the gym or see what's going on in this city. Healed up our Pokemon. Oh, let's make sure we save. That's a big thing. You know what Nappy says. Oh. So, our files. Sorry, thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys like it. Please leave a like and subscribe if you want to see more. Leave me any comments or suggestions on if I should change anything. And, so thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate it. Y'all come back next week or tomorrow, hopefully, if I can get more recordings in. And y'all have a good day. Peace.